Hey guys, so I will be explaining how to do a proper VLOOKUP function in multiple different methods today in Excel. So the first method I'd like to go through is my personal favorite, which in most cases will work for you. So say the table on the left is in order of the worker IDs corresponding to the worker names in column C, and the table on the right is sorted A to Z by worker name, and we want to pull the salary over to the table on the left from the table on the right using a VLOOKUP function. So the easiest way to do this VLOOKUP would be click on the function key here, and we're going to do a VLOOKUP. So your lookup value is always going to be the value that stays consistent within the two tables. So in this case, it is going to be the worker ID. So one way to do this is highlight the entire column as in column B and make that reference to your table array, which is always going to be the table that you are looking up your value in. So in this case, it would be table array H through J, looking like that. So your column index number is always how many columns to the right that your VLOOKUP is going to be performing. So no matter what, your VLOOKUP is always going right. It cannot go left. It will always be going right. So make sure your reference is always going to be on the far left of whatever table you are referencing. For example, the worker ID here. So in this case, our column index number is going to be column 1, 2, 3. So the number there would be 3. And your range lookup, if you want an exact match, you are going to click false, which is the case for this one. So we will do false. And we see that Jake's salary is $56,000. And over here, Jake's salary is $56,000. So we can just flash fill that down. And there we go. Table's populated. So another way to do this when your data set is not necessarily set up exactly like this one that I'm displaying right now, but there might be more data below it that you might not want to be VLOOKUP against, you can do the absolute reference way, which basically means when you select a cell, your formula will stay consistent with the cells you select. So I will be showing you this way now. So we can do this like this. So go back to the VLOOKUP function. So your lookup value is going to be your worker ID here, and we're not going to select the entire column. We are just going to select the worker ID numbers. So B2 through B11, right? So if we want this to stay consistent throughout our whole table, we are going to need to absolute reference these cells, and the way to do that is by clicking F4 in the formula function. So our table array is still going to be the same table array here. So we are going to be referring that to the table on the right, and we're also going to absolute reference those. So our column index number is still going to be 3 since it's not 1, 2, but 3 columns over in the table on the right where the salary field is that we want to pull over. So, sorry about that. And our range lookup is going to be false. So, see how the formula at the top has these absolute references in it now? We can also flash fill that down. And there we go. So, say we tried to do that without absolute references. This is what it would look like. Which is why, when you are selecting non-column cells, you are always going to want to do absolute references. So, say we just do a VLOOKUP of your lookup value, which would be this, your table array, which would be this, and your column index number, which would be 1, 2, 3 to get salary over. And you want your range lookup to be false. So, works for the first one, but notice when I flash fill this down, it doesn't populate everything. So, for example, not if you do not absolute reference these formulas, what'll happen is, see, it will the way flash fill's set up, it is set up to drag your formula down to the relevant cells, which Excel reads. So you see how on the column number worker ID 2, it goes down to row 12. And here it is not even using the full data set, and Curtis's name is located in cell I3, which is not included in this, what is selected. So therefore, we need absolute references in here. Can do that by clicking on your formula and clicking F4. So we can do this and drag it right down. And there's your VLOOKUP. And another way to do this, which is my personal favorite way, which you do not need to use the formula tool at all, is I will just go in here and click equals VLOOKUP. Just get it done really quick. So our lookup value is going to be worker ID. We could also do it by worker name in this case, I guess. So I'll show you both. So say we're doing worker ID. We're going to reference the table on the right's worker ID. And we know our column index number is 1, 2, 3 for salary. And our range lookup is going to be false. So there. And you can flash fill by when this turns into a little cross right here. And just drag it down or double click it. So yeah, that is how we can do VLOOKUPs very simply. And say we do want to do this on another key that also is relational to this table. We could also do it by name, so I'll show you how to do that really quick. So that'll also work depending on what kind of data set you have. So we could just do VLOOKUP by column C, which is the name. And we're going to reference that to the table array column I to J. Since it always goes right, you need your dependent to be on the far left of whatever you're looking up. So that's how it would look there. And then this time, our column index number would not be 3, but it would be 2, since we're referencing off worker name, not worker ID. And there we go. And we're just going to flash fill that. And we are going to get the same results. So that is how you perform a VLOOKUP in Excel. And thanks for watching. This can be used for multiple functions, and I hope this helps you improve whatever you need to use VLOOKUPs for.